Hello, everyone, and welcome to virtual math class. So today we will be talking about dilations. Okay, so our objective for the day is students will be able to understand what a dilation is and find the coordinates of a figure after a dilation has occurred. So the word dilation comes from the word dilate. And what do you know, or what do you think the word dilation means in terms of the transformations that we've been talking about? So what is a dilation? So a dilation will have an original, which we will say is the blue one. So if the blue is our original, how is the orange one related to the blue one? Go ahead and answer that now. Okay, so the orange one is bigger, right? So the orange one is dilated. And in this case, the dilation would be an enlargement, is what we call it, because the orange one is bigger than the blue one. So I kind of mentioned this on our last slide, but there are different types of dilations. There is the reduction and the enlargement. So the reduction, if the black one was our original, the black parallelogram, the blue one is smaller, right? It got smaller. So that is an example of a reduction. Think about what the word reduce means. Reduce means to get smaller. So reduction in terms of a dilation would get smaller. And then on the second one, the example of enlargement, if the black one is our original and the purple one is our after the dilation, we can see that it got bigger. And we can see that the word enlargement has the word large in it, which means that it's getting bigger. It got larger. So that's how you can tell the two apart. Okay, so now we're going to get into the content of it. So it tells us that the blue triangle is a dilation of the orange with a scale factor of 4. How are the coordinates similar? So I've already put the original coordinates over here. So it tells us that the original is the orange. So I looked at the orange coordinates. So these ones right here for the orange triangle. So I looked at the orange and I put down each of my coordinates. So now I'm going to label the coordinates of the triangle after the dilation has occurred. So I have E prime, F prime, and G prime. And I'm going to state what those coordinates are. So E prime is at the point negative 4, 8. So we have negative 4, 8. The point F prime is at 0, 8. And the point G prime is at the point negative 8, negative 8. So now, to tell how they're similar, think about what our scale factor is. Our scale factor is 4, so we know that something happens with 4. And now compare the x coordinates of each one, and then compare the y coordinate of each one. How did they happen? What happened to them? How can we get from negative 1 to negative 4? How can I get from 2 to 8? How can I get from 0 to 0? How can I get from 2 to 8? And so forth. So think about the relationship that exists and how I got from one point to the other. So we can see that if I do negative 1 times 4, that equals negative 4, right? And if I do 2 times 4, that gives me 8. So if I multiply by 4, does it work for my other coordinates as well? You are correct. It does work. So if we have a dilation with a scale factor 4, I'm going to multiply each of my coordinates by 4 to find the new coordinates. Okay, next problem. It says to find the coordinates of rectangle STUV after a dilation with a scale factor of 5 centered at the origin. So the part centered at the origin is just, it is important, but we don't necessarily need to know that right now. So right now I can see, I already have my coordinates over here written. And so based off what I learned in my previous example, what do I need to do to my coordinates in five? What's the relationship that exists there? Right, so I'm gonna multiply each of my coordinates by five. So I'm gonna do -1 times 5. Well, -1 times 5 is -5. And again, it's the same coordinate. So I have -5, -5. And then I'm gonna do 2 times 5. And what is 2 times 5? 10. And so -1 times -5 is -5. So again, I have 2, so that's 10. And now I have +1 times 5. So that's gonna be +5. And then V, I have -1 times -5, which would be -5. And 1 times 5 is gonna be 5. So this point here is S prime, T prime, U prime, and V prime. So I'm gonna go ahead and graph it now, and then you can see what it looks like. So get a picture in your head and see if what you're picturing matches what I draw. So here is my dilation after I graph my points. So is this what you pictured? And what would this be an example of? Would it be an example of an enlargement or a reduction? Why do you think it is what it is? And our last example is this: to find the coordinates of triangle PQR after a dilation with a scale factor of 1/4. So again, knowing what we know about how our dilations are related to our coordinates, what do we need to do? I already have my coordinates of my original out here. So if I'm going to have a dilation with a scale factor of 1/4, what do I need to do to each of these coordinates? If you said that you need to multiply each coordinate by 1/4, you are correct. So if I do 4 times 1/4, that gives me 1. -8 times 1/4 gives me -2. Again, 4 times 1/4 gives me 1. 8 times 1/4 would give me +2. And then I have -8, -8. So -8 times 1/4, we already know it's -2. And -8 times 1/4 would be -2. So now, did you get these coordinates correct? Is that what you got? If so, awesome. If not, remember that whenever we multiply by 1/4, that it's the same thing as dividing by 4. So I did 4 divided by 4 to get 1, -8 divided by 4 to get -2. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and graph this. So go ahead and try to graph it on your own first, and then see if you get what I get. Okay, so there are my new coordinates. And so again, is this an example of a reduction or enlargement? Why do you think that? Which one is it, and why do you think that? So now, if I think about the last example, which was an example of an enlargement, and this one, which is an example of a reduction. So the last one, I had a scale factor of 5. In this one, I have a scale of 1/4. So how do you think our scale factor relates to it being an enlargement or a reduction? What determines? So if I have a scale factor that is above 1, which 5 would be, it will be an enlargement. If I have a scale factor that is less than 1, then it will be an example of a reduction. So less than 1, reduction. Greater than 1 is an enlargement. So I hope that makes sense. If not, let me know.